big body experiments. Some of them gory.
This is not for the squeamish.
Some extreme.
It's freezing!
So are you ready? Just don't try anything you see here at home. Today, we're looking at your joints. So if you want to find out why we're doing this, keep watching.
What are you up to, Xand?
I'm trying to crack my knuckles, but they won't make a sound. Can you do it?
No, I've never been able to do it. You know, it'd be really good if we had someone here who could crack their knuckles.
Hang on. Sirach, come on out.
Hi, Sirach.
Hi.
What's with the sling?
I broke my elbow.
How did you do that?
I was running on a wall in Spain.
Are you in trouble for that?
No.
Don't run on walls in Spain. Anyway, why don't you show us how you crack your knuckles, OK? That was a lovely crunchy noise. And what's happening is that inside each of the joints of your hand, Sirach, there is a special liquid called synovial fluid. And I'll tell you what, do you both want to see what's happening inside your hands?
No way!
Look, I'm not going to actually cut your hands open. I'm just going to show you using the syringe.
See you!
Now, the water in this syringe represents the synovial fluid in Sirach's joints. And when he cracks them, what he's actually doing is temporarily reducing the pressure. And I can simulate that in the syringe. It's sealed at the end and no gas can get in. So if I pull it and reduce the pressure, bubbles form. And that's because there's gas dissolved in the fluid. When you reduce the pressure, it comes out of solution, a bit like when you open the lid on a fizzy drink. And if you pull the plunger back and then release it suddenly, you get a pop when the bubbles collapse. That's called cavitation. And we think that's what's causing the noise in Sirach's joints when he pops them. Well, Sirach, you have been a brilliant knuckle cracker today, so thank you very much. Go on, off you go, back to the cupboard.
Fine, I have things to do anyway.
All right, fine. Bye!
Bye!
So synovial fluid might be great for making a popping sound, and it probably doesn't do the joints of your hand any harm, but it can be extremely annoying, so don't do it if someone asks you to stop, unless you want to annoy someone. But the real purpose of synovial fluid is to lubricate and protect all the moving joints in your body. And in fact, it can handle a huge amount of force, so much force that we are unable to demonstrate it inside the laboratory. We are going to have to take it outside. Come on, Xand, chop chop. Now, when you do something as simple as running for a bus, your knees a force equivalent to 8 times your own body weight. Now, that might sound like a lot, but of course, the synovial fluid in the knee absorbs the force, spreads it evenly, and protects the joint. Come on, Xand.
I'm coming. I can't wait to see what you're going to show me.
My absolute favourite thing about synovial, but wait a minute, Chris. Is that a crate?
Yes.
Is that a weight attached to it?
Yes.
Wait, you don't mean...
Yes.
You're not going to...
Yes.
Wow!
Now, your synovial fluid is amazing at dispersing huge amounts of force.
It's like a cushion that softens the impact on joints, like your knees.
And that's lucky, because when a gymnast lands...
I thought I saw a gymnast back there.
Yes, this is Youth Olympic champion Taisha Mattis, who said she'd show us a few moves to help with our experiment. So when Taisha lands, up to 12 times her own body weight goes through her knees.
And we're going to show you what that kind of force looks like by dropping a weight onto this car.
Now, the weight and the distance of the car have been specially calculated to exactly represent the force that goes through Taisha's knees.
But unlike Taisha, this car has no synovial fluid.
Are you ready, Xand?
I was born ready!
This is all in the name of science.
Scientific synovial fluid experiment, go!
3, 2, 1, drop!
Look at this! It's completely caved in the metal roof of the car. And that is the kind of force that your knees are protected from by the synovial fluid.
But I tell you what, I'd be very interested to know the kind of forces involved if a gymnast was built, you know, more like me.
Well, that's easy to do, Xand. We just need to raise the weight higher to see the greater force that would go through the knees of someone heavier.
You ready?
Ready.
3, 2, 1, drop!
Xand, if you look at this broken glass, that is what the cartilage in your knees would look like if you didn't have synovial fluid and you did gymnastics.
So we've shown you that knuckle cracking makes a popping noise because bubbles from your synovial fluid burst as you flex your fingers.
And we've shown you that the synovial fluid has a much more important job than fun popping sounds. It helps your joints withstand the huge amounts of force you put on them every day.
Well, I must say, Chris, that was absolutely excellent. And that car is completely ruined. Now, how about I give us a lift back to the lab? Chris!